Greetings and salutations. This is Paul Fincannon. We're going to go look at Karen's studio today. We're walking through our very, very green backyard to get to the studio. Here's our house here. Sometimes there's a cat in that window waiting for Karen to feed it. Here is our squirrel feeding station, formerly known as our bird feeders. Another place for birds here. There's Karen's studio back there. A very dirty bottle tree as we walk to the back. Bird suet to attract the bluebirds that never come into our bluebird house. Hopefully Karen is expecting us. She has all kinds of stuff hanging out here. All this will be cut away if anyone will ever let me use the chainsaw that I bought. So far, that has not happened. Let's see if she's here. Why, hi, Karen.
Hey, Paul.
How are you?
Good. Long time no see.
Yes, it is. Probably about 2-3 minutes. So this is Karen's studio, and we're just going to give a little bit of a tour here. Let's see. Where do you want to start? So Karen has at least 3 big kilns that she uses. All of them right now are still working. The last one here was the first one we had, I think. Wasn't the big one here? First one we had?
Big one.
And I guess it can work, but it's not really operational right now. This is the digital kiln that's been working for quite some time. I'm not sure if anything's in there. Let's look. Yeah, it's empty. Here's some of the work that she has that's kind of ready to go. We're gonna make a lot more plates to go on Karen's new website, which launched today. My sister Teresa Gibson made these bowls. We're gonna put some monograms in there for her. These are some things that our nieces and nephews did over the holidays when we were here. Different little plates, just for fun. I'm not sure what's going on up here. What's going on up here?
That's some stuff that Maggie did over the holidays.
Oh, there's Maggie's. Yep. Maggie's our niece. I'm more interested in the other things that are just hanging out here. What's going on there?
Well, this is actually a finished piece that needs to be photographed, put together, this big giraffe here.
Okay.
So, this is called Ursula Discovers the First Gray Hair.
Okay. Hey, Nikika. Nikika's watching.
There you go. So,
Gene Flint. Okay, so that's going to be finished at some point in the future, right?
It's finished. It just needs to be photographed.
Okay, well, so, I'm photographing it right now, kind
of. I just don't like leaving it on top of the kiln because it's precarious. Okay. You never know what's going to happen in here.
This is very true. All right, so we'll continue our little tour here. Since no one's ever come here, except maybe Gene Flint has. Nikika, I know you haven't because you are not in this country. Let's see. So shall I show them the room? Yeah, let's go here.
That's scary.
It's a little scary room here. This is the room. Lots of the old work is. I'm starting the back because that's the only light that works right now. Karen has tons of old formulas, chemicals, all these kinds of, what are these things called?
Raw materials. Oh, all these raw for making glazes.
Yep.
For back when I used to do cone 6 glazes.
So she's, fire. So if you're in the Atlanta area and you want to come make some cone 6 stuff, come by and see Karen because she's got the goods.
I've got Gerstle borate, I've got silica, I've got tons and tons of raw materials.
Still lots of stuff down here.
Glazes and there's my scale. I've got kinds of.
She has this. We don't know. What is this thing? A sifter?
A sifter.
Okay. All right. Old glazes in here. She's got all kinds of
molds for Thank tiles.
You. Molds for tiles. This is a pineapple. She used to do a lot more tiles back in the day. Let's see what this one is. What is that one? Is that the cat?
Flamingo.
Oh, that's the flamingo. Yeah, flamingo. Lots of stuff. If you're in the area and you want to come and press some tiles, come on by. Karen can always use some friends in the studio. All right, so this is the other end, and this, as you can see, is just a disaster area. All kinds of stuff that's may get finished, was finished, got broken, whatever. It's all here. So lots of things that we kind of need to do something with. All right, turn this light out. And we'll go towards more recent things. This is where Karen does most of her work. She works at these two tables here. This one here is where she makes things. That's her glazing table over there. And that's Karen.
Slab roller, my extruder. I'm working on a custom order for a person who wants a dog portrait. So this is my template for my standard size fat animal.
Okay, while you're doing that, let's see what you're doing. That looks more like a parrot.
That's a parrot I just finished this morning.
Okay. Zoom in on the parrot.
And I keep my photo reference right there.
Okay, we'll show pictures of the parrots in case nobody knows what a parrot is.
To my books of animals that I use for photo reference and my book of dogs. So.
Okay. Hey, I've got the... I thought you were going to show us what something was going on over here.
I am. I'm good.
Okay.
I have to.
And it reminds me, we're going to have a demonstration too. Good.
So this is the beginning of my fat animal. Start out with a slab.
Whoops. Bad videography. Parrot. This is Karen's workbench here. She has all her happy animals who they're like a little kind of the island of misfit toys. Something may have happened to them, but like now they're just part of the family.
Missing an ear, missing an ear.
Yep.
missing a horn.
Just
that one's missing the tail,
but they all have a good camaraderie. They all get along together. No bickering out here is allowed. Why are you putting that on there?
That slip,
mm-hmm.
It's kind of like glue.
Okay,
so then I piece that together.
Okay.
Smooth it down.
Is this like it's like one of those big cuff things that they wear like in the old Roman days? Is that
No, it's a fat animal.
Oh, okay.
And normally when I do these, I'll do probably, 15 at a time, but today I'm just doing a couple because I only have one that needs to be done as a custom order.
So I'm assuming those are legs.
One of the legs.
Mm-hmm. Why are the legs so short?
I don't know. This is what it will end up looking like. That.
Like a broken llama?
Yes.
Okay. Zoom in on the llama.
So now I'll put these aside until they get a little bit less pliable.
Okay.
This one's probably a little bit bigger than I'd like, but we're going to go with it.
So it's going to be a big what?
It's going to be a black lab.
Okay. Why is that?
Because that's what the person wanted.
Oh.
It's a custom.
What's that over there?
What's what?
This one. Is that a sheep or something?
No, that's the stand. That might be the one I use. I'm not sure.
Okay.
So do the same thing. Score it. Apply the slip, which is actually a combination of Lana Wilson's Magic Water, which is egg keep and sodium silicate, maybe?
One of those chemicals that was in the back?
Yeah. Same thing.
Now, did you score that like that because Angel taught you that?
Yes, Angel taught me that.
Angel Stewart is the queen of pottery here in Atlanta. Pottery supplies, and she bought something for Karen long ago.
She bought a sheep for me, and she had picked it up. It was like a sheep like this, but not a dish. She picked it up by the head, and the head came off. And so she brought it back to me at a show, and she handed it to me, and then she handed me a scoring tool and a container of magic water.
So Angel, very helpful.
Yeah. So I'll set this one aside also. And then later on, I'll just put a piece of clay over this hole, then mold it and put backs on them. And that's the beginnings of my fat animals.
All right, let's move beyond that and go to other parts of this thing. And then we'll get this thing wrapped up. Stand up. Okay. So here's the little kiln that Karen's going to hopefully help me try to get fixed today. It's another one of the little test kilns where you can put some things in there and just test to make sure that everything's firing correctly. But we have a couple and they're not really working very well.
Yes, we have several things in here, but my wheel is over there.
Oh, there's Karen's wheel. Usually it's just holding things. She's going to get that out in the next few weeks because, hey, we're here at home and there's nothing else to do except do this kind of thing. These are all kinds of stamps and all kinds of fun things that Karen plays with.
My underglazes, my glazes.
Glaze wall.
Hundreds and hundreds of rubber stamps. And these I use for my fish and stamps. This is actually a cake decorating tool, but it's one of my favorite things to use on fish.
What are you doing with those pine cones there?
I just like them.
Oh, okay.
Stamps. Okay.
I think we've got the idea. backyard.
Cookie cutters. More stamps. More cookie cutters. Oh, these are my fancy Italian cookie cutters that I never use.
All right. Move over to this side. This is Karen's slab roller. She rolls out the big slabs and makes all kinds of things with. There's her glazing table. There's the wall of many silly things, some of them interesting and important. There's Elvis wearing the Burger King crown that we got in Madrid in 2017 when they had World Pride Day there. It's a lot of fun. All right, Karen, show some of your most recent work.
So this is what I've been working on for Amazon Handmade. And they're actually handmade, my sugar skulls. And I've been doing this series of daisy animals, daisy chain wearing animals. And I've done some animals I've never done before.
Such as
an otter, a loris, a squirrel monkey, a chipmunk, an orangutan, another squirrel monkey, a frog, a badger, a baboon, ring-tailed lemur, a hedgehog, a kangaroo, an alligator, which I've done before, but not wearing daisies. And did I point out the ring-tailed lemur?
I don't know. I lost you at badger.
All right.
This is some of these finished products once they are fired, obviously. Hippo, elephant, two hippos, I guess, giraffes, etc.
And
there's Brenda's ram that will be fixed. Will be fixed sooner than later, Brenda, if you ever see this.
And these are some finished pieces that need to be photographed. for the new website. This is one of my favorites that's not quite finished. This one's called Look Ma, No Hands. The little pig is riding on the back of the donkey. But I just love that little pig. And the Trash Panda, Boston Terrier, that came back from a gallery with the tail broken off. Somehow, I have no idea how that could have happened, but...
Yes, I believe they sent us 4 things broken back, and we've never heard from them again.
Right. So, I had to make a new tail for it.
That's pretty much it, huh, Karen? All right, you got anything, any other words of wisdom before we...
Here's the time, which you point out, I've been making stamps, also available on my website.
Yes, this is a new thing Karen's doing, and she's going to start selling stamps.
Texture stamps. To stamp the tiny plates, and I need to get the sweatshop.
She needs to get her sweatshop going, which basically means getting her 86 and 82-year-old parents to come up here and work.
Yeah. My dad was up here this morning mowing the lawn, so...
Yes, I was inside working, in case anyone was wondering why Karen's dad's mowing the yard. He came up here and did that, and plus my mower's not working. Anything else you need to know, Karen, about?
Nope, I guess not.
Okay, well, you're all welcome to come visit anytime. I can say that for Karen anyway. And I'm sorry we missed all the comments, but I was walking around, and... hopefully, I guess Karen, you'll see him on the interwebs, right?
I guess.
All righty. Well, thanks for coming, and
stay safe out there, everybody.
Bye.